What's the time? It's time to get chill. What's the time? It's time to get chill.
I like the Beastie Boys.
It's time to get ill.
Time to get chill, because it's chill stream.
I like the ill stream.
You just like the stream.
If I liked the stream so much, I'd be streaming on my own channel instead of joining you on yours.
It's time to eat Coffee Crisp.
Do what?
Coffee Crisp.
Oh, yeah. Didn't you say that you found some store where you could buy those, like, super cheap?
33 cents a piece.
Damn.
I bought a box.
It makes me wish I didn't have the sugar beeties. But I got that sugar beetus, so there will be no Coffee Crisp for me. So where's your sidekick at?
Huh?
Where's your sidekick at?
Doing a stream with Connell.
Why?
Because it's Connell's movie review.
Oh, okay. What movie are they reviewing?
Predestination.
Okay. Why would anyone care what Canadians think about movies? How you doing, Crafting Gamer? What you been crafting lately? This might sound a little lame, but I've been painting the hell out of ducks. Just ducks after ducks. And when I'm not painting ducks, I'm painting werewolves. Or wolfkin, or whatever the hell they're called. And it's weird because I only know of two games where ducks are a playable race. And one of them I wouldn't even dream of trying to run.
I got a comment on something you said. You said, why would Canadians care? Or why would anybody care what Canadians think about me? The first thing you asked was where Justin was. So you care about Canadians.
Of course I care about Canadians. They're our brothers to the north.
You love Justin and Bear.
And God willing, one day they'll be part of our country after King and I.
Absorb. Never happening.
Eventually we'll win. We have the
number. No, you won't. We have the water.
Yeah, but we're going to take over the water. And then we're going to get all of the First Nations people on our side.
You wish. They hate you more than they hate us.
But when we promise to give them all of their old lands back.
Yeah, like they haven't heard that fucking lie from your country before.
We're going to offer them beads and fire water.
And then we'll do the same thing when we go to Mexico, too.
You know what? I would Coffee Crisp, so good. I would love for America to take over Canada just so they would have to deal with Quebec and just see how your fucking heads explode dealing with Quebec.
Dude, see, we've got a Quebec down here, but our Quebec is awesome. It's called New Orleans.
No. That's not a Quebec. That's a cute little postcard culture. Quebec is a rich, powerful, influential asshole.
There. I got these for 33 cents a piece. I bought a box.
Fuck, how many did you buy? Basically,
it's like you're bordered by America to the south and to the east.
So, as I put it, a friend of mine asked me, he goes, I don't understand this Quebec-Canada thing. Can you explain it? I said, okay, we have to start with the premise that Canada and the United States are the children of England. And you guys had a big fight and you got into a big row with mom and dad and you broke windows and you moved out and you bought a big car and you wear a cowboy hat and you got guns and you're doing just fine. We stayed at home. And then one day mom came and said, Canada, do you think maybe you'd like to, I don't know, get your own place? And we're like, can we still do our laundry here and keep you on our money? Yes, of course, Canada. And we did. And Quebec is this hot French chick we're dating. And every now and then she says, Canada, I don't feel to do this anymore. I'm leaving you, Canada. Goodbye. I want to go. Goodbye, Canada. And we're like, no, I love you, baby. What can I do to keep you? Take me places, buy me things. So we do. We take her to international trade summits. We let her have her own trade delegation, make her own immigration rules. We call her a distinct society. And then at one of these fucking G whatever meetings, you're there. And we see, and you go, hey, Canada, how's it going, little brother? And we're like, oh, hi, America, things are good. Listen, what's with that French chick you're always bringing places? And we're like, oh, you don't understand. She completes us. She's distinct. She makes us better. He goes, no, I get it. She's hot. I tap that ass. But you don't see me bringing Puerto Rico, do you? And it's just like, there you go. Now you understand the relationship between Canada and Quebec.
I just want to point out that when you were pretending to be Canada talking to America, mm-hmm. you sounded just like Rick Moranis.
Well, yeah, that's the point. That's the joke.
You were like, oh, geez, you know.
Oh, okay, yeah, have some, sure. That's, if you read Riff's Canada, you find America annexed Canada with Canada's permission in the future. Yeah, okay, TCG, Riff's Canada is not prescient. Like, you guys do not understand our country. You do not understand the national identity of all the different parts of Canada. Maybe Alberta would really.
No, we definitely don't understand fucking Trudeau.
No, exactly. Now, Alberta, they'd probably love to be Americans. British Columbia, fuck no. Quebec, never in a billion years. The Maritimes, they just want to be left the fuck alone, you know? Ontario, got their head up their own ass. They think they're the greatest thing in the fucking world. And we all just leave them going, yeah, whatever, fuck, you know? Manitoba and Saskatchewan, who fucking knows? There's not enough people there. You know, like, who knows?
First Nations guys hanging out around Slave Lake, they really aren't saying much.
And they don't give a fuck. Like, that's the thing. The further north you go, the less of a fuck they give.
Hey, makes sense to me. So what you been up to, man? What's new?
I spent the week writing. Finally got past that. I got a little more to do, but that's fine. So tonight's my removal of my self-imposed exile from YouTube. So I saw Hunger was on, so I thought I'd come hang out for a bit. And then at 8 o'clock, I'm going to be doing a chill stream on my channel.
Well, nice. Yeah, we had like half of the game group call out today.
Ah, shitty. I was wondering why you were all here. I'm like, what the fuck?
Well, I mean, it's like every now and then the stars align, and then my one bro he's got a side hustle where he like goes to events and sells homemade products.
Okay.
So he had a big event, and then my other bro is dealing with family stuff because, you know, the whole divorced but still having kids that are not 18 or older. So there's always drama because, you know, your ex is going to use the kids to try and F you over every time they can. And then, I like that. And, then people not feeling good. And it doesn't happen a lot, but every now and then it happens. And then next weekend, I'm going to be in Virginia. So.
Oh, yeah?
And I'm probably not going to stream a game for these knuckleheads. They'll just have to.
I wouldn't. If I was you, I'd be like, shit, take a look up. Double D made that and sent it to me.
Nice. That's really cool of him.
Get it on a t-shirt.
Right?
I'm going to put it on a t-shirt.
Hunger struck.
Can I tell you the funniest experience I ever had in my life?
No, but I'm dying to hear about it.
So me and my buddy back in the late 80s, early 90s, went to see AC/DC on the Who Made Who tour, or whatever tour had Thunderstruck was their big song. And we decided to take mushrooms. We're like, let's take mushrooms. This will be fun. Yay.
We're
on general floor seating in the middle of the, I think it was the Montreal Forum was still open at that time. It hadn't been turned into a cinema yet. And they opened with Thunderstruck, right? So, you know, and then 5,000 French Canadians went, Thunder! And me and my buddy just looked at each other like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
Thunder!
I thought going to a concert on mushrooms would be fun too, and I was wrong.
Yeah, people suck on mushrooms. That's the problem. When you're around people, you're like, ah, fuck, you're all weird.
Well, I was double fucked up because I went to a Marilyn Manson concert on mushrooms.
Yeah, in a
club while he was still performing things like rock and roll African-American and stuff like that.
Rock and roll African-American. I remember when he very first started, he toured up and down the freaking East Coast to Florida, like nonstop. And his tours were all in these little hole in the wall freaking places. You could buy a ticket for like $5.
So you remember Backstreet Boys?
Yeah. You know?
So you remember Backstreet Boys, right? They were a product of Florida. Yeah. And before they hit big, they were doing shows in Montreal and Quebec City because of all the French Canadians who saw them in Florida and were in love with the fucking band. Really? It was insane because we just started like my buddy's got to do they had a concert where they decided to do a stunt show at the start of it, like to rile up the crowd. So they hired all these stunt guys I knew, and my buddy's like, "Yeah, we're going to do something for this group called the Backstreet Boys." So we spent a week straight going, "You're going to go work with the Backdoor Boys? Are you going to go work with the Backdoor Boys? How's life going to be with the Backdoor Boys?" Like, stop saying that because I'm going to accidentally fucking say it in front of them now. It's like, yep, that's our plan.
Same with Matchbox 20. Before they were Matchbox 20, they were Tabitha Secret. They were Tabitha's Secret.
I remember that name.
And they were Orlando band. And they used to tour all over Orlando all the damn time.
Yeah. Didn't they make a joke about that on Community?
I think so.
There was a Tabitha's Secret joke on Community, and it was Lisa Loeb playing the part in it. Oh my god, I want to know this now.
I finished the latest season of Rick and Morty.
I'm sorry.
It got better. No, it got like the first episode was a bit like, what the fuck is this? These voices are weird. By the end, I was like, this wasn't bad.
The thing is, I like Rick and Morty, but I hate the fans.
Yeah,
I always say. But pretty much the best episode, and I'm not going to give spoilers. I'm just going to say my opinion of the best episode is the one where Evil Morty comes back.
Yeah.
And it's like a two-part episode. And he just basically, you know, makes Rick look like a little bitch, does whatever he wants. And
yeah, that's pretty good.
And, like, his whole deal is he just wants to be left alone. Like, that's the whole reason he left the, what do they call it, the finite curve or whatever.
Yeah.
And went to wherever he went is because he just wants to be left alone, man. And he's way smarter than Rick, which bothers Rick a lot. Because the Evil Morty is, like, Rick times 10. And he's like the original Morty or some shit.
Yeah.
So it was just a good episode. It was pretty good. What's up, Leth? How you doing, bro?
We got a Leth and a Winter Willow in the audience.
Winter Willow still exists.
I've never seen Winter Willow.
Yeah. Winter Willow never comes to my streams anymore. I don't know what happened to Winter.
I don't think I've ever seen him on one of my streams.
You're not me.
She, not a he.
Jeez, okay. I mean, I assume God. Look, from my MMO career, guy until proven otherwise.
I've actually spoke to her. It's chick.
I believe you, because I believe you. But you know what I'm saying, though, right?
Yeah. Well, a lot of people come to my stream that don't know that or something.
Yeah. Assume everyone that you talk to is a dude, unless you hear their voice.
A lot of people come to my stream that don't go to other people's streams there. I mean,
yeah, but you wouldn't really used to come to my streams. So it's just basically I'm being shunned. I understand. It's okay. It's great. You shun me. It's all right.
Choose between Bear Hungar.
Shun the unbelievable.
Why you gotta make everything a competition? Why you gotta make everything an end or? What's this binary existence you live in, sir?
He's always been that way.
I don't know. Maybe you didn't subscribe. Maybe you've unsubscribed. I'm subscribed
and I never see your streams either.
Really?
I always see it on everything.
No, it's really weird. YouTube.
I seen a stream this morning, stopped and said hi.
We're at 2,038 subscribers right now. It's kind of cool.
Awesome.
That's crazy stuff.
Yeah, I don't know what happened.
I think sometimes
YouTube. When we touch the honesty is too much.
That some people don't deserve to have their.
Yes.
Streams actually looked at or something.
Yes. That would be very accurate, I do believe.
Yeah. I was watching a guy talking about, actually it was Razor Fist, and he's talking about how the algorithm works and how like If you put out one video that underperforms, it basically screws over your next three videos, unless one of those three videos overperforms. So you can get these like channel death spirals where, you know.
And I don't even know how anybody gets anything from my stream.
Okay. So, Worf, you son of a bitch. What's the matter? DS9 got you pushing too many pencils?
Oh, that's awesome.
That's fucking good.
Some haven't seen a live stream since your last Palladium game. See?
Okay. Well, I've been off for a week, so that might be part of it. But I don't know what to tell you guys. I don't control YouTube. So.
Well, Winner says that she wasn't...
Oh, she was unsubscribed. Yeah, they do that. It's like a random. They'll do that.
Yeah, yeah. Like they'll just they what they do is they think you're a bot. This is what someone explained it to me. They said they think your account for some reason is a bot, especially if you subscribe to too many people in a short period of time, it flags them. So then they go around, they just start unsubscribing you from channels, which is fucked up.
It's like Jackie from Shadow and Sun when he made his account, put out his first video, it automatically got sent as a bot.
Yeah.
And you know what the sad part of the whole thing is none of it is being done by actual humans.
No, and that's the thing. You like these are the cunts we want running the world because Jesus Christ, they can't even run their own shit.
Right. They write these weird algorithms, you know, these if this then this thing, and they just set it loose. And so, you know, every time you do something, you've got basically, it's not AI because it ain't smart enough to be AI, but it's basically measuring everything and then doing weird shit.
I want to bring up something I heard, saw a video on about Canada.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Specifically Air Canada.
Oh, what about Air Canada? I love talking shit about Air Canada.
So this guy.
Their panels don't fly off their planes?
This grandmother died. So he got a hold of, and they lived across Canada from where he lived. So right. He got a hold of Air Canada, talked to the AI bot on Air Canada websites. Like, listen, I heard you guys got something for bereavement. They're like, buy the ticket at full price, which was $1,700. And then we will reimburse you $1,200 and change off of the ticket. So he bought the round trip ticket, went to his grandmother's funeral, got home. Sick Air Canada message, and the executives or the people in charge of that said, no, just because our bot said that doesn't mean it's true. And he's like, it's your actual bot ran by your website, ran by your company who told me this. Now you're saying that it's not true. So he got pissed and got a lawyer.
And Canadians ended up to be messed with when they get angry.
It ended up suing them. And ended up getting quite a bit more than $1,200 back, I'm guessing.
No, we have limits in Canada. We're not like you guys. We have a lot of laws in place in Canada that you can't basically get rich off of a lawsuit. You can get what's reasonably expected to get for your thing because we don't have juries awarding the amounts. That's the thing. You guys have a system where you have people awarding the amounts in those cases. So they go, well, fuck that guy. Let's give him $1,000,000 because I hate that company. Whereas like here they go, all right, it was $1,200 plus inconvenience. Here's $2,400. You know what I mean? Like,
well, $2,400 is a bit more than $1,200.
Yeah. Trust me, I wish we could sue in this country like you do sometimes, especially a fucking shitty doctor. I'm sorry, I'm getting angry. I'll stop.
Well, that was like 2 weeks ago, but still, it's hilarious.
That's
Gemini AI.
One of the things I hate the most. And I don't really even remember the guy's presidency very much, but I do know that it was Ronald Reagan that made it where lawyers were allowed to advertise their services on television. And I pretty much hate that because prior to that, you had to actually go looking for them.
In the UK, lawyers and medicine and shit like that aren't allowed to have advertisements. So, in America, every other freaking commercial on TV is either about a medicine or an attorney.
Ozempic.
That's one of the reasons why I don't watch network TV anymore.
Right.
Because I hate the fucking commercials. I don't listen to regular radio anymore because I hate the commercials.
Well, Ozempic was supposed to be for like severe type 2 diabetics. But then it turns out that it causes massive weight loss.
So they put me on Ozempic. It's not, doctors just, they're lazy. So they just prescribe it now because it's their new wonder drug.
Right.
It was garbage. It was making me sick. It was causing me to be hungry all the time as opposed to actually not be hungry, which is supposed to, what it's supposed to do.
Yeah, it's supposed to be like the ultimate appetite suppressant.
Yeah. And then I looked into it after because I quit. I just stopped. And it took 5 weeks for it to get out of my system before I started feeling natural again, which is normal. My appetite shot up right after, and I put on like 10 pounds right away. But now I'm getting back on top of that. But I was reading the shit it does to your body. It suppresses your digestion urge. So what happens is there were people going to the hospitals with undigested food in their stomachs.
Ugh. I've already got that issue. I don't need no freaking drug to do that.
I was wondering if you were on Ozempic, though, because...
No, I am on Jardiance.
It's like, you know, and the way the system works, and I know this because I know somebody that's indirectly involved in it, you get a really handsome or really sexy chick in a low-cut dress or whatever, and she goes to the doctor's office, and she, like, feeds everyone there lunch, and then she leaves them a bunch of samples of whatever the drug du jour is. And then the hope is that they will then, after they get done with the samples, actually open an account and buy that drug. So you have like a whole group of basically lobbyists,
yeah,
that do nothing all day but take medical professionals out for dinner.
Here's or lunch
or whatever.
Yeah, they take them to Hawaii for medical conferences. It's insane. Right. I had a friend who used to do that for a living. She made a lot of money.
Right.
Quick update for you. Air Canada must pay Moffitt $650.88, the equivalent of the difference between what Moffitt paid for his flight and a discounted bereavement fare, as well as $36.14 in prejudgment interest and $125 in fees. So he's not even getting $1,000 out of this.
But he got something back.
But at least he got
something. I hope that what do you guys call your attorneys up there?
Barristers.
I hope his barrister wasn't that expensive.
And they have to pay the fees because they lost.
Oh, so that's good then. So it didn't
Legion. That's the nice part about one of the things about Canadian law is if you're in a legal suit like that and you win, the other side has to pay your fees.
Yeah, I was watching Max earlier. He was doing a thing. He had Palladium people on.
Max. Oh yeah, the motherfucker trying to pimp me out today. That fucker. Check this out, Hungar. Check this out. He's like, when are Kevin and Sean going to come play in our Albana game? And I'm like, what? And then they're like, maybe Bear should run a game for us for the veteran stream. And I'm like, when did I become Max Liao's whore? The fuck?
Well, eventually.
I can't believe Max Liao thinks he has a different whore besides me.
A different what? Whore besides, you're his whore?
He's my whore.
Oh, that's why he needs to feel like he's, you know, in charge of something now. Well, thank you, Winterillo. I appreciate you resubbing.
It happens to us all. Yeah, and can you imagine running Palladium for the guy who wrote it?
I would never do that. I would never fucking do that. Not a fucking chance.
No way. No way in hell. It'd be like, hey, Gary, I'm running a D&D game. You want to play?
Well, Gary, because he wouldn't give a fuck because he never used the rules anyway.
He wouldn't care because most of the rules he used were written on like old greasy napkins from like McDonald's or something.
Still, it's the guy who invented the game. I couldn't do it.
Someone has to be bottom bitch. Finally, not me.
Well, you know what? I hate
to hear that. You're making oil, you will always be a bottom bitch.
Max Liao, you need to understand something. In the orangutan world, the smallest, bitchiest orangutan gets used like a female by the rest of the pack. You are the littlest, bitchiest orangutan, sir.
And
well, it's nice that Kevin doesn't use half his rules. I use a quarter of them.
And as long as Max, if you've never talked to Norm, You don't understand. Max will always be somebody's bitch.
That's a fair point. You should come in here and defend yourself with your voice there, Four Eyes.
I'd have to send him a link.
Wow. Send him a link.
Wow.
He started it. What are you wowing about? He started it.
I'm just over here being like amazed. Just
you remember you said earlier about Canadians and anger?
That's yeah.
Welcome to it.
Seeing it.
Welcome to it.
You know? It's all fine and well until the Canadians get pissed.
Yep. The Germans learn that.
You know? Actually, Max, give that link to Nora. We don't want you on. We want the cool person in a relationship on.
So
Nora doesn't do videos. She's got bare shit to do, right?
Have any of you ever seen her? I've never seen her.
Yeah,
I don't even know what she looks like.
Yeah, there's old videos of her. And
I've seen Nora wearing a Hungar t-shirt.
Nice.
Yeah.
I mean, I believe she exists, you know, but I've just never seen her. I have no idea if she's like, you know.
I remember a few times she had to do something in the room.
Is she really Japanese or is he just talking shit, you know?
She's very Japanese.
Yeah, she comes dressed up like a ninja through the place.
She's got a woman's cut pink Hungar shirt. One day she walked into the room where Max was wearing nothing but that shirt, and he was so conflicted.
Yeah, but here's the thing. Is she very Japanese? She's from Okinawa.
Too easy.
Do consider Okinawan people to be Japanese?
Listen, you and I are not allowed to constantly get into discussions about cultures that are not our own every fucking time we're on a stream together, James.
Okay.
Like we do this.
Have you noticed
this? Have you noticed? No, I'm just saying, have you noticed this? Every fucking time you and I are on a stream together, we start discussing international cultures and history and all this shit, and Hungar gets bored.
I'm a weeb.
And says, I'm going to take a fucking nap, man.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm a weeb, and I will consider people from Osaka to be Japanese.
Yeah, he said Okinawa, not Osaka. Your weeb status is in desperate question now.
Okinawa.
Yeah, Osaka was the Japanese steakhouse down the way that we used to go to.
Osaka's a city in a prefecture, isn't it?
I don't know.
Okinawa's Japanese.
You know, I watch these fucking little cooking shorts on Facebook, these little videos of people making food, and I'm like, how did I get diabetes? I never ate like this. How the fuck did I get the diabetes? And these cocksuckers eat like this, you know?
Oh, like epic mealtime?
No. They're just like little weird shorts that come up on the Facebook, whatever they're called, reels. And they're like, you know, here's my 40-inch cheese steak with a fucking layer of French fries and then meat and cheese and gravy and barbecue sauce and fucking onion rings and more cheese. And I'm like, and how do you eat this shit and not fucking explode into like little tiny diabetic chunks?
Those mukbang people. I watch these two Korean chicks, and they're constantly going to Korean barbecue, all you can eat Korean barbecue places, and putting away like 10 pounds of freaking brisket each. And I'm like, how the hell do they do it?
Yeah, apparently a little known thing is that and it's a Korean thing, is sometimes they try to eat like a squid alive.
Yeah.
And occasionally they die.
Octopus, yeah. And
because that little bastard grabs hold of it. It's like, nope. And if they can't swallow it, then they suffocate and die.
So I don't eat calamari. I'm not a squid guy. I'm not an octopus guy. And then for years, people ask me why I went, because look at it. Just look at it. What about that is appealing or appetizing? Look at the fucking thing. But people are like, oh, no. And then recently they're starting to say that, like, they're starting to think that maybe fucking cephalopod DNA is a case of panspermia that they didn't naturally evolve on Earth and shit like this. I'm like, see, y'all been eating fucking aliens. That's what y'all been doing. You've been batter frying aliens. And when they come to fucking get their revenge, it ain't going to be a whale probe. It's going to be fucking Legend of the Overfiend. Okay. We're going to be fucked. Literally. Well, I mean,
obviously, they came about when Dread Cthulhu and the Starspawn seeped from outer space onto the Earth. 16 billion years ago or whatever.
16 billion years ago.
And back then, there were no natives.
Winter Willow, listen to all the words I say next time, you drunk maniac. They put fries. They put fucking entire loaves of bread. Their carb count in this shit is insane.
Like I said, epic mealtime. When those guys make like crazy shit and eat it, and you're like, how are you guys not dead? They must just do cardio nonstop.
Well, there's that one.
When they're not filming, they're on their freaking, you know.
Did you send Shadow the link, Hunger?
No, I didn't.
Why?
I don't know.
What has Shadow ever done to you except tolerate your bullying?
It's kind of true. Shadow does put up with a lot of shit from us.
But, yeah, that's what I think. The epic mealtime guys, they eat whatever they made, and then they jog like 15K.
He's on his way out to dinner.
Bullshit he is. He's lying. He doesn't go buy food from strangers. How would a survivalist ever do that?
They're all like in the bathroom, you know, forcing themselves.
Well, that one guy got caught doing it. The this Asian guy who was like a big trendsetter, he was doing binge and purge on that stuff. And his assistant finally, after they got fired, his assistant's like, here's truth. Yeah, this is insane.
Yeah. And what's crazy is condensed milk is like the base of every Russian dessert.
Yes.
You know, there's even a Russian kind of chewy candy, and it's just somehow they solidified condensed
milk. Yep, I've had it. My grandmother used to put condensed milk in her tea.
It's good in coffee.
No, it's not good. Listen, I watched Eat That Coffee Crisp, and I thought, God damn, I haven't had a coffee crisp in like 2-3 months. And then I went, oh, right, because I'm diabetic and I shouldn't do that.
My grandmother used to buy the canned cream.
Yeah.
And if we didn't have any milk, she would just open a can and like do a 50-50 mix with water.
Oh, my God.
And that's what she'd give us for like whatever.
Wow.
It wasn't the condensed milk, though. It was just the canned cream.
My grandmother used to buy, I don't know if you guys have the McLaren's Imperial Cheese in the States. It's this little red plastic tub with this hard, super sharp cheese that you can spread barely.
Yeah, we call it tub cheese.
Okay, well, it's here. It's really expensive. It's like $7-$8 for one of these little fucking containers.
Yep.
And my grandmother used to put that on toast with jam. And I'm telling you, man, that's like a food memory where I'm like, yeah, once every couple of years, I go buy a thing of jam and one of those, and that's what I eat, and I feel like I'm a kid again. And then I'm like, I can't do this anymore. Stop.
It's like when every once in a while I want salmon patties because my grandma used to cook salmon patties.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
But my grandma, she was hardcore with pimento cheese.
Oh, yeah.
And my mom loves that. Plus, my grandma, mayonnaise and tomato sandwiches.
Yep.
Toasted tomato sandwich, butter on the toast, salt and pepper on the tomatoes, and mayonnaise. That was what we used to take my father for lunch. My mother would make that, chop it up, and we'd run it off. Like, she'd get rid of us by saying, take lunch to your father. And we'd be like, okay. And we'd go running through the woods to his office. And that was what we had. So we'd get half a sandwich as our treat, right? For being the courier. I fucking love that. Toasted tomato sandwich. Oh, Jesus.
I like tomatoes on egg sandwiches with toast and mayo.
So that is a nice hat, by the way.
What?
Right about now, them Duke boys wishing they had some pink dinner.
Oh, that's where I got it from, too. It turns out there's a store called Cooter's Garage that does nothing but sell Dukes of Hazzard memorabilia. Like, you can buy the model kit of that Dodge. You can
buy Winter Willow.
Like, parking for the General Lee only. You know, all that kind of stuff. And it's actually cheap. This hat, I think I paid like $12, you know.
See, okay. I want you to send me one of those so I can wear it around in Canada and watch fucking liberals lose their minds.
Okay.
Would they, I mean, yeah. I don't know. I know some people view this in a negative light, but to me, it just means I'm from the South.
In Canada, it's viewed as a racist symbol.
Yeah, I get that because a lot of like skinheads, for some reason, want to fly Confederate bow banners. Yeah. I've never really got that since there were so many black dudes in the Confederate Army. It's like...
Okay, we're running into Justin territory here. Oh, look who showed up.
There he is. Well,
Justin pontificates about the finer nuances of race relations, I'm going to go make a cup of coffee.
I want to say something about the liberal blue-haired women. Okay, everybody knows I go on OME TV, which is the new Omegle, but without all the male genitalia. It's great.
Yeah, we get that over on Shadow Show now.
I play old gangster rap or newer gangster rap songs wearing my Santa Claus hat and shirt. And one of the songs I play is by a young gentleman named YG. I think that's what his initials actually stands for, young gentleman. And the song is My N-Word. Right? So I'm sitting there and I'm just like bobbing to the song. And every time a black dude or a black chick comes on and they see me singing dancing to that song, they love it. They think it's the greatest thing. They start bouncing around and singing to it. But you should see the look on the blue-haired liberal people, because you can tell who they are as soon as they come on and they see a white dude with a Santa Claus hat and a big white beard dancing to that song. It's like you can see the veins in their head just get large.
Yeah.
And it's great.
It's indoctrination, man. It's just indoctrination.
It's like Razor Fist said on one of his shows, there's no greater threat to American society than like liberal white women. It's like they're the ones that's that also an indoctrinated about statement. Everything. It's good to know that the packages I sent out arrived, so freaking Omen Al's got his shit ton of crappy dice to play his crappy Star Wars game. And the Nerdy Goblin has a shit ton of miniatures he can paint.
Mm-hmm.
That 3D printed like a year ago. So I know he's supposed to be the Nerdy Ogre, but it kind of makes me laugh to call him the Nerdy Goblin.
Yeah.
And I got to watch him because he might be out there trying to goblinate stuff. Yeah, you look like you just gave up the will to live just there for a second. There,
I'm back, bitches.
Yeah.
You don't that like
the show
stuff? You're not down with the goblinating?
No.
How was the show, Justin?
Pretty good.
Are you bridged yet?
Oh, I've been trying to find a version of Goblin Slayer that isn't in Japanese.
Crunchyroll.
Yeah, I'm not paying for that shit.
Right. You used to be able to see it on YouTube.
Yeah.
Goblins, yeah, that's how he always say. It's like, and that's all he ever wants to talk about. People walk up and they're like, it doesn't matter. They're like, hey, we need help killing the demon lord.
He's Justin,
like, the demon lord, a goblin. Justin. Nope. Well, then get out of here.
The two seasons of Goblin Slayer on my Plex have dual audio.
Yeah, but they're not in order.
Oh, yes, they are.
Oh.
I'm looking at them right now. Let's take a look.
I will check later.
Anime Goblin Slayer,
yeah.
Season one. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, those are in order. Let's go look at season two. Longer titles.
And you know, I'm okay if you guys call me a little girl here, but...
Two. Well, they're in order too, you lying sack of poop.
I don't know. I looked in your cartoon.
Yeah, whatever. Try using the sort feature a little bit better, you fucking Luddite.
Yeah. A sort feature. You're freaking. I open up your cartoon folder and it's just a bunch of random video clips. You work
for the NSA.
I work for the NSA. That's news to me.
Tell them about Predestination, Justin.
What's going on? Yeah. That was the movie on deck for Connell's show today, Predestination. And great Bruce film. I highly recommend you watch Predestination.
It's Bruce Zimbardo and Janet from Another Planet, they did a good movie. They did Spaceball.
They did, I forget what they did.
Spaceballs.
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, that's a classic, though.
Mark.
Predestination. Is that the one where the guy doesn't die, so then, like, death shows up to get him?
No.
Final Destination.
Yeah. Predestination is the one where the guy is his own father and mother and self.
Yeah,
it's based on a Heinlein short story.
Yeah, I see that. It's a little weird.
When I saw that movie, it was called
Predestination. No.
And this is
Futurama, he's his own grandfather.
This is based off of Heinlein.
No. Yeah, All You Zombies was the short story.
Yeah.
Somebody is knocking on our door.
Yeah.
With a rap, rap, rap on my back porch.
You keep on knocking, but you can't come in.
Have you seen Predestination, Bear?
Nope.
You should watch it.
I've seen it. It's mid.
It's a slow burn. I think you'll like it, Bear.
I watched a weird movie last night. It stars Ethan Hawke. It was about, well, first off, it had Nicolas Cage in it, which made it awesome. But apparently he was a college professor, and everyone started having dreams of him being in their dream. Yeah.
How was that?
I've got that on the docket to watch.
It was, like, pretty weird because basically everyone started hating him because of shit he was doing in their dreams. And he was like, I'm not that guy, you know. You're dreaming me. Right? But the dog barking made my girl cat growl. Is that code, Max?
here's a thought for you. You like crab?
Yes. I like crab, but not crabs.
Do you like crab? Do you like eating crab?
Yes.
Not really, no.
Good, because you're just fucking eating ocean spiders, you fucking weirdos.
I have no problem with eating spiders.
They're just ocean spiders.
I like spiders. I like spiders so much I don't knock their webs down.
I thought octopus were just soggy spiders.
No, octopus are fucking aliens.
They're something else.
Then I have no problem with eating the Xenos.
Shrimp is a fruit of the sea.
Shrimp is a bottom feeder.
Shrimp and lobster and crab
used to be fed to poor people and prisoners because it was the shit that got dredged up when they were trying to catch real fish.
I'm okay with that.
That's actually true. He's not wrong. Bear is a well-read guy.
So is caviar. So
when they used to take all the revolutionaries that got captured and put them on those boats off the coast, that was one of their big complaints, is all they were being fed was crustaceans.
It's just nasty, man.
I eat raw oysters, so.
I've eaten them until I've thrown up.
So you
that would take about one.
No. I ate an entire steamer tray of them once.
No, lobsters are not fish, they're crustaceans.
Yeah, I mean, that's pretty obvious.
They have an exoskeleton.
They're the insects of the sea.
The only thing that you can't eat on a lobster is the shell, but that's not true because you can pound that shit up, turn it into a powder.
And then snort it.
Diatomaceous earth.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think lobsters are supposed to be older than crabs because on a long enough timeline, everything becomes a crab.
Where's that from? I don't believe that.
Star Trek.
It's some evolution bullshit where they said everything in the ocean on a long enough timeline becomes a crab.
All right, so let's take a let me shock you. Let me shock you with something I'm about to say, given what you think of me as a person. I believe in adaptation, not evolution.
I'm not shocked.
I believe species will adapt to their environments, but I don't think evolution's a thing at all. I mean, that's just
But the argument is that creatures like trilobites and those weird sea scorpions and shit, over time, eventually become crabs.
I don't believe it.
Because
even that sharks have not evolved since the fucking Cretaceous period or whatever the fuck.
I guess. No reason.
Alligators haven't evolved. Crocodiles haven't evolved.
I have no issue eating weird foods because
evolution's not real.
I've eaten crawfish in Louisiana, and they literally call them mud bugs.
I want to say this. I heard something James said. I think it's correct. Over a long enough time, everything does become a Cenobite.
That's so funny because I watched the Hellraiser where they're in space and the deep makes the space station to try and capture Pinhead. Now, some of them are called Hellraiser and there's no Cenobites even in them.
Well, that's one of the things they did. That was one of the franchises where they would just take like random movies and add a scene or two into it to make it part of the franchise.
You love Hellraiser, bro.
The one I'm talking about is where like the dude's kid committed suicide based on a website. So he set up a thing to lure all of these people there, and then he like drugged them and buried them in the ground or some shit. And then at the very, very end, like the last 5 minutes, Pinhead shows up.
The one with Kuro War is the same way.
Yeah, there we go. My favorite Hellraiser in space movie is Event Horizon.
Event Horizon is good. And it's sad that all of the extra bullshit about it burnt.
Gone.
So it'll never...
They fucking stored the film in a salt mine in fucking Romania. Who stores film in a fucking salt mine?
Who goes
the people who did Event Horizon?
Well, the studio didn't want that ever being seen. That's why, because they cut it and then they tried to kill the film and then they released it to just get some money back on it. And then they took the film stocks and put it in a fucking salt mine, knowing full well what salt in the air will do to film.
I don't know this, but since you've been in the business, I assume you probably.
You assume what?
That you probably know what salt does to film. Because
God, salt destroys film. And it eats through the canisters. They put it in these tin canisters, right? Right. And the salt will eat right through that shit. This is not like they store it in salt. It's a salt mine, so there's fucking sodium in the air. Circulating. Vaporized. You know what I mean? So it just eats into all the metal. It eats into anything that salt can degenerate. And salt can degenerate a lot of shit, buddy.
Yeah, that's a big thing in Eastern Europe. There's like huge salt mines in like the Czech Republic and Poland.
There's a really large one in Spain, too.
Slavs became slaves. And when you had slaves, you put them to work in the salt mines.
Right.
It's a really big salt mine in Spain.
That one tribe literally changed its name. The Serbs were originally called the Serbs.
Yeah.
And then they got so sick and tired of being servants, the servile, because they were constantly being enslaved by the Turks, that they changed their name to the Serbians.
It's still my favorite thing when I watch living ironically in Europe, the guy who's he's Serbian, but he's like lives in Romania now. He does all these videos about the Balkans and trying to explain the Balkan culture. Yeah, every time he shows the Turks, it's some sort of cockroach. It's just like, fucking hate the Turks in the Balkans.
There was this one British show, and it was the same way. They'd be like, I don't like you. I am sophisticated. I am a gentleman. You are Turkish. Everything they were just... Live. Yeah, they're just totally nonstop making fun of Turks.
They had like the French woman, and she's like, I am a well-to-do, highly educated French woman, and you are a Turk. And it was just like, wow.
That Ottoman shit carries a long fucking tail, is all I'm saying, right?
I mean, Albanians are basically just Turks.
I don't like Albanians.
Don't tell them that. You know, you want to fucking punch in the throat? I'd stab you with my knife. Like,
Well, what's that? What's that Carl line? You got to get fit before you get stabbed with a knife. I love that one.
What's that one line?
Aqua Teen Hunger Force. Watched it.
Sorry, was that what?
Kosovo is Serbia.
Oh my god.
Like anytime you're in anything and anyone brings up Kosovo, there's always like nine people saying Kosovo is Serbia.
Yeah.
Except they spell it, you know, Slavic, so it's like Kosovo is Serbia. Yeah.
My last landlord that I was like in Vancouver that I really got along well with was a great landlord. He was Croatian and his wife ran him. She ran him, but he didn't give a fuck. He'd just drink all day. That's what Joe would do. Joe would drink all day. But Joe is the kind of landlord you go to him and go, hey, Joe, the rent's too high, man. Can we, what's a good price for you? Can we knock 50 a month off? Yeah, okay. I like you. 50 a month. Okay. It would be like he was that kind of, you could just negotiate the rent with him halfway through the year and he didn't give a fuck because of one simple reason. I was a bouncer. And my friends were all bouncers who were coming around the apartment all the time to hang out. So he loved it because there was all these big, scary guys around keeping the crackies and the junkies away from his building. So he fucking loved me. Loved me.
Yeah, Croatians are considered the femboys of the Balkans.
No, that's Albanians.
Is it Albanian? Yeah.
Albanians, they're always giving them that fucking anime weeboo chick look in their stuff.
Oh my goodness.
No, not Albanians. Sorry, Slovenians. Slovenians, I gotta rewatch my fucking Ironically in Europe guy. Yeah, it's Slovenians. Are these
I'm going to play a video.
Okay. Is it Slav Life?
It's not Slav Life.
Okay.
Is it some like.
Is it Justin's mom?
I wouldn't wish that on anyone, bro.
Tell me what you know about Slav.
It's pretty bad.
Croatia.
Somewhere near Romania, it's Europe and NATO. Why the hell do we go? Pristina blew up ahead, or Macedonia, Albania. Somewhere far overseas,
the Swedish NATO troop.
There's a place called Kosovo. That's where you don't wanna go if you're Albanian at all. Protecting human rights, airstrikes and firefights, and we'll be dropping our bombs wherever Serbian bad guys hide. Just up from Kosovo, Somalia, Romania, or rescuing Cumania. We screw ya, Rwanda, wish we could have helped ya. Iraqi, embargo, Rosalie, how's it out in Kosovo? We'll kick some ass and then we'll see how it goes. Hey, man, we really don't know. Good luck to Kosovo.
Except no one has any respect for blue helmets in the bar. You can end this one, Larry.
It's stupid. It's not stupid. I'm loving this.
It's dumb.
No, it's hilarious.
People seem to forget the time when the Serbian guy rolled up for because he told them if they didn't do it, he would just fucking kill them all.
That shit's hilarious and you know it.
Yeah, it was great. Could have been a little better.
And then the Russians landed all their troops in Kosovo, which meant NATO had to deal directly with Russia. Because it's like, oh, you're going to keep bombing.
We're not talking about geopolitics here. We're talking about funny video.
Yeah, but the video was political.
That's where you don't want to go if you're Albanian at all.
Except the Albanians make up like 70% of the population. They're
which is a good reason to bomb Kosovo.
And every now and then the Serbs block off like their portion of the town.
Barry, you want to go over to your channel and talk about something else?
See, I think you would be all about this since the Croatians were on your boy's side back in World War II.
Oh.
poor Justin. He's just like,
oh. I'm not sharing one with you, Hungar.
Living in the USA.
This was a huge hit in Eastern Europe when it came out. I supposed to have the lyrics. Oh, don't tell me it's just a fucking sing along. Hang on.
Aloha. We are from Romania. Good Dallas Beast. It's our country. It's very, very beautiful. The girls are very fuckable. I'm yellow good. Expensive cars on the road. Every cat, every dog has an iPhone. Life is life, don't shoot my sheep. Francesco, you're a general, I'm perfect thief. Hey, hey, why are you living in the USA? It is not the place to stay. Hey, hey, I'm just shedding my grass if I may. Don't tell me that you are gay.
The one little line in the middle is their women are completely unfuckable.
Obama, please catch for me Osama. I call Lucre Santana. Fruit, verde, apple, pere, Sarkozy. It's drinking no my berry. No, Michinaste.
Romanian from here on out. Anyway, this song, there was an actual fucking attempt to get them to enter it in Eurovision.
It's the nice entry
from Romania. It got shot down, but I just love the fact that Romanians were like, yeah, no, let's send this song. The song that basically talks shit about America and Europe and talks about how fuckable Romanian women are. And if you live in the US, you're gay because the women are ugly. It's like, Jesus Christ. The one thing the Balkans will all agree on, like, you cannot get the Balkans to agree on the fucking color blue. Okay? Like, you cannot. They hate Americans. They despise Americans.
Can you blame them, though? I hate Americans. I love America. I love America. I love my country. But I hate the motherfuckers who live here.
Yeah.
Especially that one over there.
No, I love that one over there. The one I dislike the most is that one underneath me.
I don't live in your country.
Canadians. I love Canadians, except for one.
Yeah, that's such bullshit, and you know it because you've literally called him your sidekick.
No, I called him my side bitch.
You love Justin.
I do. Justin brings a lot to the table.
Hey, now we're not doing
my second chin, mostly.
Not doing weight jokes. Come on now.
Justin also, when he eats, takes a lot from the table.
Yeah.
I had a very small portion of spaghetti today.
Did you
I
see
how much I had a shirt that I bring nothing to the table?
What was that, Bear?
Hungar bought a box of coffee crisps that wound up working out to 33 cents each. They cost $2 a piece here.
Yeah. I got a box for $6.
Discount.
$6 and change, and I got 24 coffee crisps.
If you look, there was a markdown discount. Like, they've been sitting on a shelf. And
they were like 3 years old. Or some
they are not old or anything. It's just this, the store that I shop at, they buy overstock from other stores.
Yeah, so they sat on a shelf somewhere else for 3 years.
I don't care. They still taste good, and they don't cost $3.75 like they do here in America.
Yeah.
When you can find them.
And everybody knows if you put it in the freezer, it lasts forever anyway.
That's right.
Yeah.
We're not Japanese.
They're coffee crisp. They don't last that long.
Coffee crisp, skim milk, mammoth steaks. Freeze that shit.
I don't buy skim milk because it's a liar. And I don't like liars.
There's no skin in that milk whatsoever.
No, the skim milk's not milk. It's white water.
My mother grew up in a dairy farm. She used to say that too. The best part is, they fooled everybody into thinking it's healthy. Like, nothing will ever impress me more than your nation's ability to convince everybody fat, bad, sugar, good. I will never in my life see another societal coup of that fucking level perpetrated against educated humans ever again.
Well, you,
holy you shit.
Used the word you shouldn't have used.
Which
educated.
Is?
Educated.
No, no. At the time they pulled it off, your country was one of the best educated countries in the fucking world. And then suddenly, sugar became the biggest food additive and fat started to disappear and you became one of the stupidest countries in the world. I'm not saying there's a correlation.
It's really. Funny. When Mexico won't even use high fructose corn syrup in their sodas.
Actually, they switched over. Four or five years ago, they switched from... Yeah,
Cuba doesn't. I think Cuba still doesn't.
You can still buy Mexican soda, Mexican Coke, uses pure cane sugar. No. I bought some the other day.
It lied to you.
Well, that's a possibility.
If we went to shit after World War II, I would agree.
I would agree.
I have said it before. I'll say it again. And I've had people tell me I'm wrong. And I'll tell them to their face they're fucking uneducated or dumb when they say that because sadly they don't realize it. But when they killed Kennedy, it was a fucking coup in your country. And they have never given up the reins since then. Kennedy was the last actually elected president in your fucking country.
I concur.
Not disagreeing.
I would agree with you.
But back to painting more ducks.
Yeah, exactly. If I know politics, Tungar and Justin might get upset. No politics talking there, boys.
Mm-hmm. It could have got... I think it started going to shit with Woodrow Wilson.
I highly...
Isn't he the one who let the Fed in?
Yeah.
Yeah. And he said on his deathbed, you know, I wish if I could have done one thing, it would have been to have actually stopped the Fed.
Yeah.
I highly recommend everybody look into Project Venona.
I would recommend everybody who can afford it and who's not dying in the next year or so to move to the Philippines.
Project Venona, spelt like Winona, but with a V instead of a W.
Venona Project was the United States counterintelligence program initiated during World War II by the United States Army Signal Intelligence Service and later absorbed by the National Security Agency. It was intended to decrypt messages transmitted to intelligence services of the Soviet Union. Initiated when the Soviet Union was an ally of the U.S., the program continued during the Cold War, when the Soviet Union was considered an enemy. Okay, what am I looking for? What's the big secret?
Well, the entire list of names that... The communist hunter guy. Oh, his name's right there.
He wore a dress.
No, the
Edgar Hoover?
No, the
McCarthy.
The whole list of McCarthy's names were on that.
McCarthy was not wrong.
Yeah, well,
this is the sick fucking part of American history. He was not wrong.
The evidence he was expected to be able to use to move those prosecutions forward were the Venona files. And at the last minute, he was denied the declassification for them.
Oh, neat.
And that's why, like, you ever see the movie Good Night and Good Luck?
Yeah.
Yeah. I would have loved one more scene at the end of that movie where the camera's panning away from what's his face at the podium. He's at the Meet the Press event for the media and politicians. He's giving a speech.
Nixon?
No, Good Night and Good Luck was
the media guy.
Yeah.
The news guy. Fuck.
Deep throat? Yeah.
No. It's a famous American media guy. Jesus Christ.
Barbara Wawa?
Edward R. Murrow.
Murrows. So instead of panning out and going to black, fade into color and be over the shoulder of Bill Clinton as he's declassifying Venona, because if that had been declassified when it was promised to be, McCarthy would have never been sullied in the media. The attempt to sully him in the media would have been shut down right there because the evidence
American media has been redder than a fucking...
Murrows was red.
Since fucking before World War II.
What I think's funny...
Fred Fredley is
a retired
fucking
There's a retired CIA guy. Retired CIA guy. And he's all over
YouTube. A dozen of them.
All over freaking podcasts with people talking about all these missions that he did while he was in the CIA, right? And people believe it. And it's like, do you really think that the CIA, the most secretive organization pretty much there is letting some guy who was in the CIA out there talk about all this shit, like, without getting disappeared or... Or getting Clintoned? No.
So during the 80s, I used to laugh as a young man every time I'd see some fucking, you know, white-haired American conservative going on about, you know, the CIA this and the CIA that. And I'm like, the CIA ain't nothing but shit. And now today, living in the world of 2024 and having done the research I've done, our entire modern Western fucking degeneration is CIA programming.
Yeah.
From the fucking media bullshit all the way down to fucking the fucking everything. It's insane how much shit that organization has done.
Yeah, it's this guy. He's going out on doing podcasts and shit and YouTube videos.
I saw him on Joe Rogan.
Yeah, you know that he's still working for the CIA.
Mm-hmm. Once Gloria in, never Steinem out.
Worked for the CIA.
What? Gloria Steinem? Yeah.
Gloria Steinem was a CIA asset, fuck.
Yeah, well, that's why I said Wham, right? That was her Women in Media.
Her magazine never made a fucking profit. Never made a profit.
Julia Childs was a spy.
Month after month. What?
Julia Childs,
yep,
worked as a spy.
Yep.
Yeah.
Did she?
Yeah, she was OSI.
Wasn't she married to
like
an ambassador?
OSI was Venture Brothers.
Venture Brothers, yeah.
Yeah.
But she's married. Her husband was the French ambassador.
Right. So she could always go all these places.
Mm-hmm. I still prefer to call it OSI. It's funnier.
Well, I mean, the fucking Chuck Barris used to say that the trips on the fucking Gong Show were CIA trips. Like, basically, the CIA would pay for the trips that they would give away. That's why if you ever watch the Gong Show, you win a glorious trip to Czechoslovakia. And they're all like these fucked up Eastern European locations. It's like, yeah, you'll spend a full fun time week in Croatia. You know.
Yeah. You'll be going with you, your wife, your children, and Steve.
Every single one of them had a handler while they were there. And the handler's whole job was to just fucking, he was there for the CIA doing his thing, you know? And everyone, Chuck Barris is full of shit. Dude, Hollywood has been so up the CIA's ass and the Communist Party's ass since, like, its inception, practically.
Yeah. Oh.
Oh, I long for the days of Steve McQueen and Clint Eastwood and, you know, tough guys. Real fucking tough guys who weren't pussy fucking lefty commies.
I don't know. I get Clint Eastwood.
I do know. I was alive when they were around.
But Steve McQueen always just come off depressed to me.
It doesn't matter. Steve McQueen kicked the shit out of you, and that's what mattered.
Yeah.
He could be upset. He could be depressed and whip your ass just as good as doing it happy.
I can imagine
someone trying to get Charles Bronson to understand pronouns? What the fuck are you talking about? I can just see him. What the fuck's a zur? I don't know. She's got a zur. Fucking pussy. She's a she.
It's the guy that raped my wife. Boom, boom, boom.
That men do.
Oh.
I'm Charles Bronson. I just dug a ditch with my face. Fuck, that guy was a tough motherfucker.
Oh. I bet you Chuck Norris don't use no pronouns.
I'm not on the Chuck Norris bandwagon.
Chuck Norris beat Bruce Lee's ass.
Yeah, in a fucking movie.
By default, he lived.
In a movie.
That's fucked up.
Chuck Norris is a really good joke.
Oh, but no. That Tim Rockwell movie was really good.
The Chuck Norris movie
was good.
But if you're actually talking, though, about Charlie Bronson, I mean, that guy.
Now, what was that
movie? Like, back in like the 60s.
Yeah, what was that guy that did the movie Moon?
Wasn't Charles Bronson like half or a quarter native, like Choctaw or something like that?
Yeah,
could have been, but he was the bad guy in High Noon.
Yeah.
Oh, my darling, don't forget. And all that shit. He played a bounty hunter that was hunting somebody through Saskatchewan or some fucking place. It was all mountains and snow. Of course, he had all the where he was the old dude that moved into the apartment building and killed all the gang members.
Sorry, like my apologies.
Death Wish or whatever.
Death Wish, yeah, Death Wish.
The evil that men do. The one where he's always playing that freaking harmonica.
He was Lithuania.
Shows up, yeah, he was actually Turkic
from Lithuania. Yeah, him. Weird.
So speaking of...
speaking of the Eastern Bloc.
Yeah.
I miss the Iron Curtain.
It was the best curtain.
Well, one of the bars I used to work at in Montreal, we had the Czech consulate was right next door to it. So every time Czechs would escape to fucking Canada, they'd wind up there. This wasn't a Czech consulate. It was like a processing station for Czechs who made it out, right? And they would give them a fucking free pitcher coupon to our bar. So at least twice a week, twice a month, we'd have these fucking Czechs show up. And the women were so fucking hot. Sadly, they all stank because mouthwash and deodorant was not a big fucking priority for the Czechs at that point in time. It was the Cold War, after all. But Jesus, these women were hot. And, you know, school, they really liked Western dick, and we'll just leave it at that, you know?
I know. I was married to a Slav.
Yep.
They're crazy.
First wife was from Czechoslovakia, and before she had immigrated, she was a ballerina.
Oh, yeah. Ballerinos. You lucky bastard. I love ballerinos, man.
Crazy. I never understood why he divorced her, because she didn't want to divorce him.
Hungar's gay. You ever figured that out yet?
Yeah, seriously. Hungar's a little AC/DC.
No, I don't think so. And I've known him his whole life.
Yeah, you're blind to it. You're wearing that hat.
Well, the videotapes come out.
What's wrong with this hat? I'm from the South. Get the fuck used to it.
Yeah.
It's bad as hat, Justin.
If you hate the South, then why do you keep moving down here?
It should be a patch on the front, and the rest should be orange.
You need to put your little...
You can rise to 0-1. It's an orange hat, and it has a 0-1. And on the top, it has the battle banner, so it looks...
You need to put your little squishy skull thing that you have on it.
That might be... I mean, Justin would love it. Everyone else would hate it.
You put a little Totenkopf right there? Is that what you're going to do?
The little death head pin? Oh. Yeah, I don't...
Oh, I like me a Totenkopf. That's a nice historical...
The greatest taxidermist ever.
It was...
Has one of those on his hat.
Yeah, what was his name? Something Testa?
Chuck Testa from Ojai Valley. You know, I'm going to play that video.
And if you look really close at his hat, he's wearing a Africa Corps hat with the death's head on it.
Africa Corps is...
But he's from California, and you know, those people are weird anyway.
I'm going to play the song.
There's a song?
Bears left. He's like, I want nothing to do with this. You're
like, I want nothing to do with all this shit.
I'm out of here.
Oh, yep. There he is.
You probably thought this deer was alive, and this coyote was alive, and this pheasant was alive. They're dead. They've been tested. Your mice like Chuck Testa and specialize in the most like dead animals anywhere. Period.
Look at that antelope driving a car.
Nope. It's just Chuck Testa. Nope. Chuck Testa. It's just Chuck Testa.
Oh no, there's a bear in my bed.
Nope. Chuck Testa.
There's a leopard sitting on an impala out on my deck.
Nope. Chuck Testa.
Did that rhino just order a drink?
Nope.
Chuck Testa. A real person, I wonder.
Just Chuck Testa.
Oh, no, there's a bear in my bed.
When did I? What? There's a list.
No, Chuck Tester.
Do that.
You guys play the original.
When did I start doing acid? What
was that?
As Chuck Tester.
But he didn't play the original, so he kind of screwed you over.
No, no. I feel like I started doing acid when I saw that, so I think it hit the right spot.
Okay. I get it. I mean, okay. If he played the original, it's an actual commercial for a taxidermist in somewhere California.
Completely Ohio Valley.
And everything. Call me, I'll taxidermize whatever, right? And the whole video is him being like, oh no, see, here we go.
You probably thought this deer was alive. And this coyote was alive. And this pheasant was alive. Nope, they're not. They're dead. They've been taxidermized by Chuck Tester. Ojai Valley Taxidermy. I specialize in the most lifelike dead animals anywhere. Period.
Look at that antelope driving a car.
Nope, it's just Chuck Tester.
Oh no, there's a bear in my bed.
Nope, Chuck Tester.
Well, that's creepy.
There's a leopard feeding on an impala out on my deck.
Nope. Just Chuck Tester with another realistic mount. Shipped to me from anywhere. Call Chuck Tester for the most lifelike dead animals around, period.
Did that rhino just order a drink?
Nope.
Chuck Tester does not taxidermize pet.
That can't be real.
Yeah, that's real.
That's from some comedy show. That's no way that's real.
That's real.
I don't know.
America.
Definitely freaking weird.
Like, when did they bring back the whitest kids I know?
And what's up with the...
Bear's Googling it.
It's fucking real. Ojai,
California. He's got a phone number. And Chuck Tester does not taxidermize pets.
That's sad. How am I supposed to get spot?
So there is that.
Did you guys hear about that mount they found in a rich French person's house that's been abandoned for like 100 years? It was two. They found this like freaking texturized frogs fencing in a French manor that's been like abandoned for 100 years or some shit.
I've seen the picture. Like,
good to know that people back in the day were just as fucked up and weird as we are now.
No, they were more fucked up and weird.
Yeah.
They just had less technology to express it.
Yeah, the French, they got a really bad history.
Enjoy this bone.
Like serial killers and stuff. Like they had a lot of them.
You probably thought this deer was alive and this coyote was alive. That's
I bet you thought this bone wasn't real.
Here you go, Hungar. Just for you, buddy.
Ron.
Nope. There we go. You ready? Here you go, Hungar. It's the future ex-wife.
Yeah.
Her entire YouTube channel is just that.
If you got an itch, stick with it.
You got an itch, scratch it.
Well, I think in that case, you don't scratch, you stroke.
Oh my God, Justin! What is wrong?
I'm gonna have dinner in front of God and everyone, Justin. It's time for dinner.
Oh, is that the end of Hungar's show? Okay, well, my show starts in 37 minutes.
I got a game tonight, so.
You got a game? You playing Shadow's little game? Yeah. You could be a fucking pirate of gay water?
Yeah. You got a problem with the gay waters?
Yar, I'm gonna tap that booty. Yar.
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 Plunder me.
I will plunder.
Man overboard.
Are you playing AD&D or?
Yeah.
Actually, never mind. I got nothing. Cool. I was going to try and put something together with AD&D, but I'm like Justin, who keeps talking when he does that. I realized I had nothing, so I'll stop.
Justin's off, just went with it. He's like, that's right. I'm going to get that booty.
Get that booty.
Jack that ass like a looter in a riot.
Caribbean.
Anyway.
We're going to have Brenner for dinner, I think.
Brenner? Who's it? Is that someone you met? And you're
breakfast. Gonna chop them up? Breakfast Brenner? For dinner?
Kylie Brenner?
Fried eggs with sausage and gravy, and I think I might make some homemade biscuits.
Well, you do you, sir.
I had carbs with a side of carbs and some pasta sauce.
You're going to miss your foot, Justin.
No, yep. I'm doing good. I love my feet.
No, there's sadly, if you don't have the genetic markers for diabetes, you will never get diabetes, and that's the sick part of it. I have a friend 100 pounds heavier than me, eats anything he wants, doesn't get diabetes. Me?
I bet your Lizzo sweat sugar.
Speaking of CIA ops.
Fucking Lizzo. Oh,
God.
It's like they say, it's like a woman is set and say that Lizzo's a 10. She's beautiful. That's what beauty standards are. But as soon as you compare them to Lizzo, they get pissed.
Yeah, there's that meme. It's like when you say Lizzo's beautiful and it shows women smiling, when you say they look like Lizzo, they're all angry. Once upon a time in the West. That was the last comment a long time ago. But that is a good movie.
And Charlie Bronson was in The Great Escape with Steve McQueen.
Was
it? Did you ever see fucking...
is that the one where...
Eddie Izzard's routine about the Great Escape? If you ever get a chance, look up Eddie Izzard's routine about the fucking Great Escape. He does this entire fucking routine about that movie that's fucking hilarious. It's like 10 minutes long, but it's so funny.
Isn't that the movie where McQueen had that green Mustang?
No, The Great Escape is where they're all prisoners in World War II in Germany.
What movie did McQueen have the green Mustang?
He played a Canadian in that movie.
He may have been a Canadian for all we know.
Steve McQueen?
Yeah. A lot of you guys jumped the border to come down here and become movie stars. Shit. For 10 years, every news reader on every major channel for the most part was Canadian.
It's because we're better at elocution than you are. He's from Beech Grove, Indiana. That's where Steve McQueen is from. There's a beach in Indiana. That kills me.
Bullet. It was Bullet that he had the...
Yes. Bullet's a good movie.
Elocution.
Thank you, O'Neill.
Elocution. It's the pronunciation of words.
Yeah,
he can enunciate.
So the Columbia Media School in New York teaches the Canadian neutral accent. The reason why they teach this accent is the one I have, because I had to learn this in broadcast school as well. This accent is considered the clearest, most understandable English accent in the world by all English speakers. So they taught all their newscasters to speak like that for 30 fucking years in the States. And then they stopped. Right around 2000 something or other, they stopped because basically Fox News changed the game for everybody. But before that, that's why all those guys sound alike, is because they're all taught to sound like neutral Canadians, right?
Yeah, because we're neutral, damn you.
You in trouble?
Not me. That's not
you getting, getting a talking to from Mrs. Master?
No, she told me to be very careful because she ordered a couple of boxes of Taco Bell stuff. And...
Ooh, Taco Bell.
Justin's on a plane. he's off to Pearson. He's going to go to a fucking plane to get to
you. Well, a steak burrito supreme only has 400 calories.
How many carbs?
No. This is the thing. They did the, you know, the old Subway challenge? The Jarrett before he got his AIDS.
Funny.
Children. They did that, but with Taco Bell, and it actually fucking worked.
Yeah, because Subway bread is cake.
In Ireland, because of the laws in Ireland, the amount of sugar in Subway bread, they have to classify it as cake, not bread.
Yeah.
I hate Subway.
Not talking about politics, but the Irish completely crushed.
Oh, it was brilliant. It was fucking beautiful. Oh my God, I loved it.
They were trying to like put all these amendments into the Constitution, and the people were like, no. By like 70%. They're like,
yeah,
nah.
All the fucking happy DEI people living in Belfast and fucking Dublin were, you know, like the cities are all like, you know, not Belfast, but, you know, Dublin and all that are all like, we're advanced and progressive. All the Catholics in the country are like, fuck that, mate.
You saw not Scotland, happening. Right?
Fuck off.
You saw Scotland, right? They posted their update like that with the anti-hate law, and everyone started reporting it for being racist. Because it meant the definition under its own law.
Do not fuck with Celts. That's like my grandmother told me when the fucking when the peace was settled and Sinn Féin and all that shit, she said, we'll give peace a try. But don't forget, everybody's got at least one gun wrapped in oilcloth buried in the flour bin, you know? It's just like, yep.
Sinn Féin was the good guy. Terrorist group is they only targeted military targets.
Mm-hmm. And they called first. Always call first, even if there's no bomb.
Like they would kill cops and English soldiers, but they wouldn't just randomly blow up a disco.
No. So look, Irish terrorism
or a hospital
was the most civilized form of terrorism you'll ever find, and it's all they could do given what they were up against. Let's keep that in mind. Right. Indian Revolution was to sit down and let the British look like assholes.
Tried the Sepoy uprising.
Well, they tried, but it failed.
That worked for a minute,
was over. But when Gandhi got in there and he said, no, we're just going to sit on our asses and let the British look like fucking pricks to the world. And that worked.
Yeah.
Why is it the place between those two extremes of our world can't learn these fucking lessons?
Right. Yeah, but they committed a bunch of stuff that was really bad during the Sepoy uprising. But when the redcoats showed back up, it was like genocide time.
So what are they supposed to do? Set out their ass while they're building bombs?
It was like...
if you want them to meet in the middle.
No, I'm just saying it was
military targets only. Military targets only. Always call even if there's no bomb because it puts... They have to go on full alert regardless. So it puts fear and it wastes resources. And when they show up to fuck with you, sit down and let the cameras catch them fucking with you. Because they're going to kill your people anyway. Either way you fucking slice it. Like, I'm terrified to find out what's going to happen if Russia figures out where those pricks that did the 133 at the concert hall are from. Because we're going to see Russia do a fucking Middle Eastern war on that point. Because fucking Putin's going to go put a boot up.
Yeah, Putin's not going to put up with that bullshit.
They caught them fleeing to the Ukrainian border, apparently, eh?
Yeah.
There was the four guys who did the shooting and seven of their accomplices were trying to get to Ukraine.
That's what it's called now. Well, once Russia annexes the whole thing, it's officially being renamed Ukraine.
Being renamed Kiev.
The Principality of Kiev.
Yeah, exactly. They're going to call it the Novogorod and leave it at that. You know,
they'll establish a principality. Just we are the monarchy, except for in this one territory.
I watched the interview with Putin and Tucker Carlson.
Yeah.
And the first 35 minutes is just Vladimir Putin telling you the history of all of Russia.
Yep.
With no cue cards or no freaking nothing. He's just saying, 5,000 years ago, this and then that and then this. And Kiev used to be the capital of Russia, but then they moved to Moscow because he wanted it more centralized. And it was just like, our president doesn't even know where he is.
Oh, I got to show you something. Okay, hang on. Wait. Hungar, this is going to make you laugh. Hang on. I got to get this for you. This is going to make you fucking laugh.
Our president doesn't even know what America is.
Hang on. This will fucking kill you, Hungar. This is so fucking funny.
Well, that's not good.
Well, don't die.
It's not Tuesday, man. Wait.
Okay. Ready?
Don't die, but
he wasn't famous. His local Starbucks would be like, oh, that old guy's here again. Shit. They never know what he wants. You get him. It takes him like an hour to order. Come in like bling bling. Hey, it's me, Joey B. Give me a mocha chocolate. Not chocolate. Come on, man. You know the thing. hot brown, baby. Hey, did you shit my pants or did I? No, I'm being serious.
No, seriously.
Did you shit my pants or did I?
If I was the barista serving fucking Joe, he would come in, order something that way, and I just put like random crap in front of him every time. Never the same fucking thing, and definitely not what he ordered.
What the funny is, they say that he's not mentally capable of standing trial, but he's mentally capable of running
a country.
That's what I was going to say.
He's mentally capable of being the leader of the free world, the commander-in-chief of NATO, but he's not.
For what it's worth, Vladimir Putin endorsed him in the next election.
Oh, of course he did.
If I was Vladimir Putin, I'd endorse him too.
The Iranians, the Chinese, the North Koreans, and the Russians do not want Trump back in power. Because notice how well-behaved all four of those fucking nations were while he was in power.
Well, they didn't have to be fucking aggressive with anyone.
Trump's best line ever was, you got a red phone? I got a red phone too. It's just it was his best line.
Yeah.
I told him.
No, his best line was when they killed that one guy and he's like,
he died like a dog.
Like a dog. He was crying. He was a crybaby.
He died like a dog. Make a racket great time, again.
Trump cut weapons.
We're going to spice this. Flow, baby, flow. The spice is going to flow.
At the same time, during Trump's administration, he cut weapons transfers to Ukraine because he knew that this was being prepped.
Yeah.
Right? You know, and it's like, why would we want to start that shit?
Listen, if you need proof that the media, and I promise you, at some point in the future, history is going to remember Trump as the most media, anti-biased media president, like the media was against him. And if you need proof of that, look at the bloodbath spectacular that just happened.
Yeah.
Like, holy fuck. Could you not just stand up and say, we are MSDNC, and get it over with at this point in time? Because, Jesus Christ, that was not fucking media. That was just propaganda.
What's funny is all of the gangster rappers that are coming out pro Trump now, all of a sudden,
and all these white fucking liberals are like, hey, well, you're black, you can't be for Trump.
Like Snoop Dogg came out for him, freaking Ice Cube come out for him. It's like,
well, he's a brother, he's got a mugshot, he lives in Florida, and he bangs bad bitches. That's his problem.
That's true, he lives in Miami. He's banging bad bitches. He got a RICO charge on him. I mean, the dude is practically black.
Grab him by the puss.
There you go.
All right, guys, I need to eat.
You guys are more racist than I am.
Yeah.
And that's saying something.
Yeah.
That's actually from a song
where the rapper says,
you're just burying yourself in the hole, bro.
No. There's a rap song where the guy's like, he caught a RICO before I did. He ain't going to snitch because he knows the street code and all this shit. And he's talking about Trump.
Sometimes I think that the wrong side might have lost.
Every day I know that the good guys lost that war. Every day.
Peace, love, and chicken grease, everybody.
We're an occupied nation. Everything south of the Ohio River is occupied by foreign power.
Everybody say your thing. Go watch Bears show in like 23 minutes.
Thanks, Hunger.
Go by Heroic.
If you disagree with what I said, feel free to hit the unsubscribe button.
The Hunger's channel.
Not on Hunger, on me.
Justin,
you can unsubscribe to me too, Adam.
What?
Record that cackle and sell it to a video game company for like the next fucking bog witch they put in The Witcher 5.
Right?
All right, guys. Be good.
Bye now.
Bye now.
Party on.
Bless your heart.
He left again, leaving us live in his stream with him not in the room.
Well, I highly recommend you all subscribe to Bones.
We're all still live.
I know.
Are we still live?
Yeah, still live. Look up at the upper corner. Upper left hand corner. We're still live.
Look at that. Yeah, I'm gonna go eat some Taco Bell and maybe play some Scythe. I don't know if you guys
have ever. Hey, I left the studio. I didn't end the fucking stream. I'm a retard.
I don't know if you ever seen that board game, but Scythe is pretty good.
I don't
Innis is really good too. If you're into like Irish stuff,
I don't play games. Games are for losers.
Yeah, my favorite game is going outside and touching grass.
If you drop the GR, yes, my favorite game is going outside and touching ass.
I'm in the stream now.
Okay, bye.
Party on.